One of the spookiest prospects of the reality of our universe is the idea that all may not be as it seems. We collect data, do experiments, confirm attributes and laws of the universe, but there are also unknown areas of science that not only do we not currently understand, it's a very real possibility that we may never understand them because it's simply not possible to do so. There may be knowledge that the universe simply doesn't allow us to know, by virtue of not providing a means to figure it out. This ranges from all sorts of ideas within science, from the multiverse, which may never be testable, to what if anything existed before the Big Bang, again, which may never be testable, to other dimensions that may only ever be hinted at, but ultimately can't be proven. But perhaps the most disturbing of these ideas is the concept that the universe may actually be some kind of simulation that might run on completely unknown rules, such as a prohibition of a full understanding of the universe, and thus the simulation can't be proven, baked in by whatever the simulator is, if it's anything at all. So here are 10 solutions and their implications to the simulation hypothesis. Number 10. We are the byproduct of an alien simulation. One of the most vexing aspects of the simulation hypothesis is that it appears to be impossible to know for sure what its purpose would be. That would only be known to the simulator, if even that. There's no rule that says it has to be rational or have a purpose. In fact, it's possible that we are an unintentional side effect of a simulation, a peripheral byproduct of something greater. The idea goes like this. An alien civilization in a progenitor real universe sets up a simulation of a universe so advanced that it is indistinguishable from reality to anything inside it. The simulation may be for purely scientific purposes. An example would be how to study how universes ultimately form and evolve from the moment of their Big Bang to the cold end of the universe. This may have a practical purpose. The alien civilization may be interested in seeing what the end of their own universe will be like. We already construct rudimentary models like this in science, but this would be a model on a much grander scale than anything we've ever dreamed of or are likely to ever do. But in a complex simulation, complex things can happen, and in this case, abiogenesis on a planet that leads to intelligent life purely by chance and accident. Perhaps it's so rare and unintended that it only happened once in the entire vastness of the simulation, leading to the possibility that we are alone and the great silence is to be expected of a simulation of a physical universe. This may all seem very complex, probably impossible in our own universe to ever do, and highly unlikely overall. Just the same, we don't and probably can't know what the rules of other universes are. Complexity on this level may be humdrum and mundane to them, whoever they are. Number 9. We are an ancestor simulation. Answering the question of who the simulator is, if anyone, probably lies beyond any abilities we might have available to us in the universe, but it can be speculated upon. And here the option is that these simulators are us. In the far future, humans, or whatever we ultimately become, decide to look back and simulate what the universe once was, perhaps to probe their origins. This gets into sci-fi territory with a basis in science. We don't know what actually kicked off the creation of the universe, and ultimately if it's repeatable. Nature likes repeatability, and science bases itself on it. This should extend to the universe in general, opening up the question of whether we can create other universes, since nature obviously doesn't prohibit the creation of universes or else we wouldn't be here at all. This opens up the possibility that far future humans might create universes of their own, perhaps to escape the death of their own progenitor universe. They might fine-tune and tailor that universe to be amenable for their life, perhaps even better than the one they originated in. This might allow them to create a universe far better for running simulations than the one they had started in, but it may also be that they want to explore their past, and that the simulation that is our reality is a sort of echo of what once was, explored by the simulators to learn of their origins, or perhaps relearn what it is like to be human. There are absolutely no indicators that this is the case, but it's an interesting thought that can't be ruled out. Number 8. We are a computer simulation. Envisioning the simulation of a universe is a tricky thing because one can easily get trapped in biases. Here there are more possible biases than can be counted, because every shred of our existence from the moment we are born and onward is defined by and happens within our universe. Outside it, we simply don't know what the rules are. Take the idea of a computer simulation, which is perhaps the most often cited example in simulation theory. We only say computer because we do simulations on computers, so it seems a natural thought. But computers are human-made constructions based on human-made concepts, such as numbers, that are designed to make use of the rules of the universe. That said, we have been enormously successful at using numbers, and those rules, to describe our universe. So it may hold true for anything outside the universe doing the simulating. It could in principle be a computer of some sort, but if so, is there a way to try to determine if something is doing the computing? Cue in the findings of physicist Dr. James Gates, who has noticed uncanny similarities in physics with that of a specific type of error-correcting computer code. This idea really is hidden in the mathematics of string theory and may not mean anything, and string theory may not be correct. But it's an interesting thought nonetheless. Perhaps somewhere in new physics will be a way to test the simulation hypothesis. Number 7. The Unknown Simulator. Talking about simulation theory is to skirt the fringes of science and philosophy. It's a kind of could-be, but probably not testable idea. These are always problematic, and generally lie outside of mainstream science. In general philosophy, and remember science is a philosophy, PhD means Doctor of Philosophy, these questions can be tackled more broadly. But again, they may end up always being an open question. But again, here we run into the question of unknowns and anthropomorphization. Human philosophy is, well, human, and there are no guarantees that anything running a simulation from outside the universe would conform to that. As a result, unknowns crop up everywhere in this question. And that includes the option that whatever is simulating the universe may never be understandable, and may have motives or means completely irrational to our minds. This would be the non-understandable simulator, where the more you know about it, the less understandable it is. In short, it may not be a computer, it may not be a sentient being, it may not be sane, and it may not be anything you can conceive of, even if you ever find evidence of its existence. Number 6. Nature's true guise is simulations. The simple truth is, we don't even know if reality is reality. We just know our own reality and base everything we do on it. At least most of us try to. But there are aspects to our reality that when you look at them in a certain way, they are utterly absurd. Take quantum mechanics. On the level of the very small, you run into realities that look more like simulations than any reality in our day-to-day world of the huge. This includes virtual particles that pop in and out of existence from within the quantum foam, something from nothing, or the universe itself, which is also apparently something from nothing, or spooky action at a distance, where two particles can be entangled even at great distance and share instantaneous changes in state, or quantum non-locality, where a particle can disappear and reappear halfway across the universe just by a random chance, or the infamous double-slit experiment, collapsing a particle's wave function just by an observation. The world of the small is not the same reality we experience in the world of the huge, but it's a reality nonetheless, to the point that if certain quantum effects didn't exist, our technology wouldn't work. Or take it to the realm of the huge, dark matter. Think about what exactly is proposed when invoking dark matter. Most of the universe must be made up of invisible matter that can pass through walls. While it must be there to explain the gravitational effects we see, providing our understanding of gravity at huge scales is correct, it really amounts to a kind of scientific ghost story, matter that is but isn't. Again, certain properties of the universe more resemble simulations than an absolute reality. As mind-bending as that is, also within physics are interpretations of reality, such as the many-worlds interpretation, where reality spawns alternative realities infinitely. Everything that is possible to happen does so in different timelines. That idea actually exists in mainstream physics, but it's absurd, even if it's real and correct. This would be beyond billions, really infinite timelines, all representing different realities. Again, Could it be simpler that nature is a simulator rather than a reality and spawns billions of simulations, all centered on the same theme? We'll almost certainly never know. But there is a somewhat chilling proposition that the simulator, like nature, is completely unthinking, and that we simply live in a natural process, as weird as that may be. Number 5. Fever dreams of a Boltzmann brain. The idea of infinite time looms large in cosmology. There are only two options. Either time extends infinitely into the future, or it doesn't. Both options come with some disturbing possibilities. If time does not go on infinitely, then what stops it? Does that imply an ultimate end of the universe? If it does extend infinitely in the future, it's even worse, because it means that everything that can happen will happen if you wait long enough. This also applies to an infinite universe, which ours could be. Couple an infinite universe with an infinite amount of time and strange things can happen. This evokes the Boltzmann brain thought experiment, first proposed by physicist Ludwig Boltzmann in 1896. It goes like this. If you wait long enough, particles will come together to form objects of any complexity, including a conscious thinking brain, if only momentarily. In an otherwise dead and dark future universe, wisps of consciousness will repeatedly arise. If one of those wisps of awareness were to persist for long enough of a time to look around, see the universe as a lonely black nothing, and concoct either a simulation of what it was once like, or invent a dream of an ideal or fantasy universe, it could be what we see. We could be the fever dreams of a Boltzmann brain supercomputer. This one also comes with some baggage, however. In some theories about cosmology, a concerning possibility is that our own human brains are far more likely to arise from fluctuations, complete with false memories, than they are in how they actually appear to have come about, opening up the possibility that we are not what we seem, and ourselves are Boltzmann brains. Number 4. The Brain in a Vat Matrix. This concept is used in philosophy for thought experiments. It provides a method of thinking about exactly what reality, truth, mind, and so on actually are. It's an old idea, going back ultimately to René Descartes' evil demon thought experiment, and in its modern form simply posits that if you could put a living brain in a jar, give it all the nutrients and oxygen it needs to survive, and then connect it up to a supercomputer that feeds it sensory information, then it would be a kind of simulation, indistinguishable from a real world, even though it may not be any such thing. This is very similar to what was depicted in the Matrix movies, where an out-of-control artificial intelligence keeps humanity captive by keeping their physical bodies confined to pods and feeds them sensory information of a world very much unlike reality. You can never prove nor disprove this one. There's always a chance that the simulation takes the form of the brain in a vat, and that's what we are. Meaning that in some sense, we may live in the Matrix. Mr. Anderson, indeed. Number 3. You are the simulator. Cogito ergo sum. I think, therefore I am. Words made famous once again by René Descartes. The idea here is that the simulator is actually you, in some other reality, modeling a different or perhaps identical version of yourself. After all, who wouldn't want to take a look in an alternate reality version of oneself? Here the motive of simulation really just boils down to curiosity about oneself, and alternate versions thereof. And while we don't have the capability of running simulations of this nature, some other version of ourselves may. This aspect may be related in some way to the many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics, where an original simulation diverges from the moment of its inception onward into infinite parallel realities, all being simulations. This one, however, seems the least likely, because the resources involved would be titanic, at least from our perspective. On the other hand, in an alternate universe, the word resources may have a completely different meaning. It may not matter, in which case, as simulations, we would be very different indeed from our alternate counterparts doing the simulating. It's a bit disturbing, though, to think of oneself merely as a guise of something else. Number 2. Echoes of Universes. One of the biggest questions in cosmology is if there were previous or will be future iterations of the universe. This is Roger Penrose's cyclic cosmology, where a big bang happens, the universe exists for a time, and then another big bang starts the process over, and that the evidence of this may be searched for in the cosmic microwave background radiation. Whether this is the case remains to be seen, but it does open up the possibility of a scientific simulation designed to illustrate those cosmic cycles. It goes like this. Some future universe decides it wants to simulate and model a previous iteration of their universe for scientific study. Doesn't need to be perfectly accurate, it just needs to tick a few boxes for the simulating civilization's objectives. The result is that we exist in some future universe's scientific investigations into cyclic cosmology. One can only hope that they don't decide anytime soon that their objectives have been met and shut the simulation down. Number 1. The Mirror Hypothesis. Another interesting idea within cosmology is Neil Turok's concept of a two-sided universe, one where time moves forward, stretching from the point of the Big Bang, and an anti-universe that stretches backwards. If this is indeed how the universe works, it's a natural thing to investigate if you can and have advanced enough technology, is to probe the other universe. If that's impossible, you might model it instead, and thus creating a simulation. Only a highly advanced civilization could ever do this. The computing power would be beyond anything we can imagine. But if it were possible, then our universe would then be a model running forwards in time, in an anti-universe running backwards in time. That might create a very strange set of affairs for the anti-universe counterparts, where they start out wildly technologically advanced, then slowly lose it before de-evolving until their world eventually becomes uninhabitable and then non-existent, as the process as we know it runs in reverse. Eventually the whole thing stops at the moment of the Big Bang. Granted, this is highly speculative based on cosmological ideas that would be very difficult to prove, but then our own universe is beyond strange. What exactly is it, other than all that ever was, is, and ever will be? Does it have a purpose? Could it be a simulation? We may never know, and those questions may still be around in the far human future. But I leave you with this idea. Does any kind of simulator of universes have to be conscious and thinking at all? We probably can't ever know. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently lamenting the turnips. Oh, there's that music.
John?
Anna, you're on the wrong channel again.
I just thought you might like to know that the concept of a Boltzmann brain applies to any physical object.
No, that's just great. Boltzmann opossums. Like, we needed that. Wait a minute, that might explain him.
Not really, John. He's quantum mechanical. He did not appear by random chance, but rather, he emerged from the quantum foam. It all makes perfect sense to everyone but you.
Yeah, so wait a minute. If it applies to all objects, Boltzmann LeBarons, if you wait long enough, a vintage LeBaron will appear by random chance. You can't keep a great car down. And on that note, like, subscribe, and hit that all-important bell if you want to be notified when I release new content. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.